Welcome back, everyone, for the continuation of our Vandal Hearts playthrough. Now, for some reason, if you're just randomly jumping in at this point, I want to take a second to recommend you go back and start from scratch, mainly because I've explained all the mechanics, the technique side of it, and all the strategy side of it, because that's what we're looking at in this. It's a 100% more advanced run. So, let's get going. So there's no treasure chest on this level, but we do have two hidden items, one of which is here under the shell. And the other is this crater. One thing that's important about this battle is that while it may look pretty easy, pretty standard enemies, we've just got our whites which are basically sword units, and we've got our bugaboos, which are just archers. The bugaboos actually have an extreme range. Clint is so far behind in levels, we do want to really focus on him. While not neglecting everyone else, the more characters we can get to 20, as sooner as possible, the better. See, they may not do much damage, but they attack a lot and have a big range. So we've just lost Sarah straight off in her first turn because of that. As we're already down one healer, now I have to be more careful. Now usually you'd want to do something like phase shift first so that it can damage all the enemies, probably not kill them, but not be counterattacked. So something like Darius could move in, attack one of those and not be counterattacked. But I wanted to get the extra bonus of kill XP for Alina, just because she's nearly 20, so it would be easier to get her up for a class up. So from our existing characters and our XP, it looks like Zohar will hit level 20 if we use him right this round. Or this level. I don't think anyone else will hit it, but we can catch people up maybe to about 19 or so. One thing you have to consider here is as soon as we move off this bridge onto the south side, everyone at the top of the hill is going to have access to us when it comes to ranged attacks. They're so high up elevation wise that their aim is just going to be increased to drastic amounts.
Thank you.
See, as soon as we made it across that bridge, we got into the line of fire. And not only is their range drastically improved, but because the elevation is so high, their damage is also drastically improved. see how far he can attack us from basically the other side of the map. All because of elevation and range. Now it's time to drag this out ever so slightly, just so we can try get Zohar to level 20. He needs 19 experience, should be attainable.
Bye.
believe I only need 11 XP to level up Zohar here. Two kill shots though, so it should help. Unbelievable, he is 1 XP short of leveling up. Now, thankfully, we can move forward to our trade city, Karachi. We do have a few characters to level up after all. So, first things first, dojo. We want to see our first level 20 second class changes. So Huxley is going to be our first one. Now you'll notice Huxley only has one option here, because your second class change is actually dictated by your first class change. If you go for bishop, you have archbishop. If you go for monk, you have a different one that's limited specifically to the monk path. Same with Sarah. She moves on to Archbishop as well. Those are our only two for the moment. We do have a bunch of characters on level 19, so they should upgrade in our next battle at least. Especially Zohar, who only needs 1 XP. So I believe these are all the same ones that we had before. can see by the description of these life orbs that are now first on only on sale here from, well, our first place at least. They're pretty useful. And there's our gold axe. Attack plus zero. So you can see it is basically useless, only designed to be sold. Oh, that's the wrong one. We can actually continue into Carlo's mansion. Now, before we move on to the warehouse, we'll just take a break here, save our game, and explore the warehouse in our next part.